the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good morning.
Father.
Muy buenos días a todos. Le damos gracias a Dios por otro día. Pues iba a decir nublado, pero no está nublado, ¿eh? Hay mucha ceniza. Así que, pero pues Jesús nos acompaña en todo momento. Hoy voy a ofrecer la misa en tiempo de pandemia, para que el Señor pues nos siga fortaleciendo en este momento difícil para muchas personas. With a humble and contrite heart, let us ask God for His forgiveness.
Lord Jesus, you loved us so much, you sent your only Son. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, by your shed blood on the cross, our sins were wiped clean. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are seated at the right hand of the Father and will intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us everlasting life.
Amen.
Vamos a ofrecer esta Santa Misa por la salud de Alfonso Junior García y el alma de Andrea Ávila, que descanse en paz. Let us pray. Almighty and eternal God, our refuge in every danger, to whom we turn in our distress, in faith we pray, look with compassion on the afflicted, grant eternal rest to the dead, comfort to mourners, healing to the sick, peace to the dying, strength to healthcare workers, wisdom to our leaders, and the courage to reach out to all in love, so that together we may give glory to your holy name. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Escuchemos la palabra del Señor.
Lectura del libro del profeta Ezequiel. En aquellos días, el Señor me habló y me dijo: Hijo de hombre, profetiza contra los pastores de Israel y diles: Esto dice el Señor: Ay de los pastores de Israel que se apacientan a sí mismos. ¿No deben los pastores apacentar a las ovejas? Pero ustedes se toman la leche de ellas, se visten con su lana, sacrifican las ovejas mejor alimentadas y no apacientan al rebaño. No fortalecen a las ovejas débiles, no curan a las enfermas ni cuidan a las que están heridas. No hacen volver a las descarriadas ni buscan a las perdidas, sino que las dominan con crueldad y violencia. Mis ovejas se han dispersado por falta de pastor y se han convertido en presa de todos los animales salvajes. Mi rebaño anda errante por todas partes, por los montes y las colinas. Mi rebaño anda disperso por toda la superficie de la tierra y no hay nadie que se preocupe de él, nadie que lo busque. Por eso, pastores, escuchen la palabra del Señor. Mi rebaño ha sido expuesto al pillaje y se ha convertido en presa de todos los animales salvajes por falta de pastor. Pues mis pastores no se preocupan por mi rebaño. Se apacientan a sí mismos y no apacientan a mi rebaño. Por eso, pastores, escuchen la palabra del Señor. Lo juro por mi vida, me voy a enfrentar a los pastores para reclamar mis ovejas y destituirlos de su cargo. Los pastores ya no volverán a apacentarse a sí mismos. Les arrancaré mis ovejas de la boca y no se las volverán a comer. Esto dice el Señor. Yo mismo buscaré a mis ovejas y las cuidaré. Palabra de Dios. Al salmo responderemos: El Señor es mi pastor, nada me falta. El Señor es mi pastor, nada me falta. En verdes praderas me hace reposar y hacia fuentes tranquilas me conduce para reparar mis fuerzas. El Señor es mi pastor, nada me falta. Por eso un Dios fiel a sus promesas me guía por el sendero recto. Así, aunque camine por cañadas oscuras, nada temo, porque tú estás conmigo. Tu vara y tu cañado me dan seguridad. Tú mismo me preparas la mesa, a despecho de mis adversarios. Me unges la cabeza con perfume y llenas mi copa hasta los bordes. Tu bondad y tu misericordia me acompañan todos los días de mi vida y viviré en la casa del Señor por años sin términos.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus told his disciples this parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a landowner who went out at dawn to hire laborers for his vineyard. After agreeing with them for the usual daily wage, he sent them into the vineyard. Going out about 9 o'clock, he saw others standing idle in the marketplace, and he said to them, "You too, go into my vineyard, and I will give you what is just." So they went off. And he went out again around noon. And around 3 o'clock, he did likewise. Going out at 5 o'clock, he found others standing around and said to them, "Why do you stand here idle all the day?" They answered, "Because no one has hired us." He said to them, "You too, go into my vineyard." When it was evening, the owner of the vineyard sent to the foreman, "Summon the laborers and give them their pay, beginning with the last and ending with the first." When those who had started out about 5 o'clock came, each received the usual daily wage. So when they first came, they thought they would receive more. But each of them also got the usual wage. And on receiving it, they grumbled against the landowner, saying, "The last ones worked only 1 hour, and you have made them equal to us, who bore the day's burden and the heat." He said to one of them in reply, "My friend, I am not cheating you. Did you not agree with me for the usual daily wage? Take what is yours and go. What if I wish to give this last one the same as you? Or am I not free to do as I wish with my own money? Are you envious because I am generous?" Thus, the last will be first, and the first will be last. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. So, Lupita, when you go to work, you expect to get paid, right?
Yeah.
Okay. And if someone comes later and they do the same work, should they get less?
No.
Ooh, Frank says no. It's only fair, though. They did less work. That's not how the kingdom of heaven is. God is generous and offers grace to all people. Those who find God early in life or die young deserve the same grace that those who toil all their life and live a long life. What about those who have lived their whole life as a Christian in contrast to someone who's old and accepts God with their dying breath in their final days? Do they deserve the same grace?
Yes.
Correct, Frank, they do. The lesson's very apparent. Whether we begin to follow Christ as a young person or in midlife or at the end of our lives, we are all equal. But the one who enters early has a responsibility to stay the course, to work diligently in the field all day. No matter when you agree to be in the employ of the King, you agree to do the best you can all day or all your life. As a man, it's difficult not to have a job, to not have work, to stand around and wait for someone to hire you. In this parable, we see that God does not want anyone to wait around waiting to be asked to work. He says, "Come into my field, for the harvest is plenty and the laborers few." God does not care for the amount of work, but the love with which the work is done. So today, let us go into the vineyard and work diligently for the Lord. Cuando vas a trabajar